Until now, we have ignored the spatial context in our models. Instead, we assumed that the system components, described by state variables, were homogeneously distributed in space. This made our model less realistic, as transfer of mass and energy in space is clearly an important part of how real systems work. In this video, we will explain how to include the spatial context in our models. We will do this by showing how to formulate and incorporate rate laws due to transport processes. First, we look at transport processes at the level of the conceptual diagram and mass balance equations. We start by considering one specific state variable, which can be, for example, the concentration of a nutrient in a water column, N. Without transport, the state variable N changes in time only due to the interactions with other state variables describing the system. This is because N is assumed to be homogeneously distributed in space. This interaction can be through processes such as chemical reactions, ecological interactions, etc., as we have discussed in other videos. We lump the fluxes representing these processes into one quantity and call it the net flux due to reactions, or the net reaction rate. This can be represented in a simplified conceptual diagram where there is only one arrow going into the state variable N. Note that by this lumping, we do not suggest any approximation of the model. We only do this here to simplify the drawing of the diagram and to simplify the writing of the mass balance equations. In reality, we always need to consider all state variables and write down expressions for all fluxes that add or remove mass or energy from a given state variable. To include transport, we no longer assume that the state variable N is homogeneously distributed. Instead, we consider that it varies in space. For example, we consider that N has different values in spatial locations 1, 2, and 3. These spatial locations can represent, for example, different segments of a river or different layers of a water column. As a result of the spatial heterogeneity, the state variable N at the given location changes in time, not only due to interactions with other state variables, but also due to interactions with the state variable N in other locations. We lump the fluxes representing these spatial interactions into one quantity and call it the net flux due to transport, or the net transport rate. Thus, the overall mass balance equation for the state variable N at a given location has two components, one describing the net interaction with other state variables in the same location, and one describing the net interaction with the state variable N in other locations. We call these two components the reaction term and the transport term. Note that the other locations are most often the immediate neighbors in space, but they can also include distant locations. Now we explain how the transport term is formulated mathematically. Typically, the flux due to transport is denoted as J. Our aim is to find out how the variation of this flux in space affects the variation of the state variable in time. To answer this question, we consider a volume, delta V, as shown in this diagram. We assume that the substance enters or leaves the volume only through the front and back faces. We denote the location of the front face by x, its area by ax, and the transport flux perpendicular to this area by jx. Similarly, we denote the location of the back face by x plus delta x, its area by ax plus delta x, and the corresponding transport flux by jx plus delta x. If there is no reaction, the amount of the substance inside the volume delta V will increase at a rate given by the products of Ax and Jx, but it will decrease at a rate given by the product Ax plus delta x and Jx plus delta x. This is because the area is in square meter, the fluxes are in moles per square meter per second, and so their product is in moles per second. If we now divide both sides of the equation by the volume delta V and assume that this volume does not change in time, we can reformulate this mass balance equation for the concentration of the substance, which we denote by C. Finally, we approximate the volume by a product of the area through the middle of the volume and the length delta x, and assume that the length is infinitesimally small. This yields the general form of the transport term, as shown in blue. Note the minus sign in front of the spatial gradient of the product A times J. We recommend that you pause the video now to digest this result. We conclude that when we combine the effects of reactions and transport, we obtain the following general form of the mass balance equation. The concentration of the component changes in time at a rate that has two contributions. One is determined by the rate of the reactions with other components in the system at the same location, and the other one is proportional to the variation of the flux in space. Note that a similar mass balance equation is formulated for each component in the system.